in movie one, we mention Eddie Brock when Robbie is saying we had Eddie all over it and he couldn't come up with anything. I don't know if you remember in movie one, there is a scene in the Daily Bugle. In order for us to really, really beat up our hero and complicate his life, as you know, Eddie Brock was his real competition. But with Topher, we were able to bring his competition to Eddie Brock in the books was a muscle guy, and our Eddie Brock is the wonderful Mr. Ripley. He's a formidable competitor. He's intelligent. He's annoying. he's good looking. He's a real competition.
Peter is not a, his exterior is false because he has a very strong interior, but his exterior is, you know, he kind of wears hoodies and drives a moped and, you know, is kind of a bumbling guy. And we all know him to be a really true hero and a wonderful person. Eddie's almost just the opposite. He's, you know, rides a motorcycle. He's really slick. He uses a lot of product in his hair. And, you know, he's a little bit of a tan and wears shades and he's much better with women. But that is just an exterior and his interior is very weak.
And action.
There are no boundaries playing a villain. There's kind of, you know, I'm used to playing a protagonist, and there's kind of like a bell that goes off in your head when you realize maybe you're going outside the bounds of reality. But here I'm playing like kind of a half psychopath, half alien symbiote. So there is no bell going off. I mean, I go as far as I want to, and it's fun to have that kind of freedom, especially in a big film like this.
Active! And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I think in all the Spider-Man films, every character, I mean, most notably Peter, but every character has two paths in front of them. And what's great is Eddie is kind of the examination of what if he hadn't gotten that great advice from Uncle Ben, which is with great power comes great responsibility. What if someone received the exact same power, but was filled with bitterness and jealousy? And how would he misuse that power?
Okay. Cut.
What I love is that there's such a genuine love for all of the characters, and I share in that in a way because I was a fan before I was, you know, asked to be in the film. So, you know, it's funny when I'm sitting on set with Peter Parker or Mary Jane or, you know, Harry, or I see them going through something, and I'm genuinely curious as a fan, and then to be entering some of those relationships and just watching them change and just knowing what the plot is before everyone else does. It's a big part of the fun for me. I come before you today, humbled and humiliated, to ask you for one thing.
I want you to kill Peter Parker.
Thank you.
shot.